Now, again, as we said, we're not sure what caused this. It could possibly, and we emphasize possibly, have been a ground impact of a Scud. It could have been a ground impact of a Patriot, or it could have been the result of debris falling between the two of them. We just don't know right now, but we do know that at least two Scud missiles incoming were fired at Riyadh, and according to the Saudi military, they were both shot down. Charles Jaco, CNN, reporting live from Saudi Arabia. Was almost exactly 2 hours ago when the sirens went off here in Saudi Arabia. Where we are in eastern Saudi Arabia, there was no problem. However, there was an intercept elsewhere near the capital city, Riyadh. We've got some videotape of that you can take a look at right now. Hi, Atlanta. We're about to have a short course in missile identification. This is a Scud. You can tell it by its distinctive label. Now, when the missile is launched, the first thing you look for is the plume sticking out behind it. Now, when you detect this, you can tell it's been launched. Thank you.
See the graffiti on it?
Yeah, show me the graffiti.
Larry King show or bust. Look at this.
Look at this.
Look at this shit.
Look at this. Believe that. Let me say hi.
The top 10 things about Saudi Arabia.
Yeah.
Maybe we could shorten the list to 5.
Oh God, Geopolitics by Dan Quayle.
Je suis un journaliste américain.
Wolf.
Wolf.
Wolf. Oh, I love this country so much.
You guys just don't have a clue.
Well, Cheryl, it was almost exactly 2 hours ago when the sirens went off here in Saudi Arabia. Where we are in eastern Saudi Arabia, there was no problem. Now, let me just size my mask and fit it for a second, just like I always do. Stand by. All clear. What are they saying? Are they saying all clear?
Yes, ma'am. I can't hear.
Were they saying all clear down there just now?
Okay.
All clear. All clear. Etabien was a false alarm. Got that, Atlanta? Standing down now. I'm gonna go get my hamburger and my coffee.
Good. We just got the all clear.
All clear. Every time I order something, this happens. All clear. Thank you.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. I'm starting to get real bothered by all this. Boy, did I almost look stupid. Charles Jaco, CNN, reporting live from Saudi Arabia. No, wait a minute. Whoa, hold it, homeboy. I'm the talent here, you dig? A couple of explosions, what may have been an outgoing Patriot ground-to-air missile, some reported airbursts that may have been an intercept of an incoming Scud missile. We're really not sure. All we know is that the air raid sirens have gone off, and we've heard the outgoing roar of at least one Patriot missile. We've heard some sort of airburst. We can't tell where it was from where we are right now. We're waiting to see what's happening. As you can hear, the air raid sirens are still going off around us. People are, strangely enough, used to it. This is the first one of these attacks that's taken place early in the morning, but they're not showing you anything other than what we've got now. What did you see there? Is that a missile going out? We're not quite sure. We can't show you anything else than what we're seeing right now because of military regulations. We are not allowed to show you where the missiles might be going, what direction they might be flying in, where the airburst might be taking place. There's obviously something going on. We heard another dull roar that shook things a little bit, and we're waiting to see what else is going on. Right now, that's about all we know, that something is happening. We're hearing pops and things shaking, but people are staying relatively calm around here. People evacuated in an orderly way to the shelters, but apparently there is something going on. The Patriot missiles, we're assuming they're Patriots, have gone outbound, and we've heard some explosions, that's about it for right now. We'll get back to you when we know something else. Something is happening here, and we're watching, we're scanning the skies for something else. coming in, but right now we can't see much of anything. And frankly, this is what we can show you on television right now because of military restrictions from both the Saudis and the U.S.
CD, if you need to take cover, I notice that you've got your gas mask in your hands. If you need to put it on, please do so. If you need to take cover, please do so. If you are able to take a question, did you think that the possible threat would be over because it is now morning there? It's what, just after 6 o'clock in the morning?
Yeah, the whole thing is everyone assumed that the threat would be over because it was early morning. But the thing about Saddam Hussein is that he has never done the expected. And right now we have, once again been surprised with the unexpected, an air raid, an apparent attack, although we can't say what the outgoing missiles hit, at approximately 20 after 7 in the morning Saudi Arabian time. All the other attacks have occurred from 10 o'clock at night till 4 in the morning. This is the first one to take place in eastern Saudi Arabia during the daylight hours. Now, that sound you hear behind me is the hotel.
Richard Thicker.
It's not the national.
By afternoon.
So people are looking up in the skies, scanning the skies to see what they can see. Do we see much of anything out there? Can we see much of anything? Okay, well, apparently there was some word of outgoing. Again, there we cannot be specific about the direction. All right, we are now led to understand that there are also firings in another city in Saudi Arabia. CNN's Carl Rochelle is here with me. He just came up. Carl, I know we can't be very specific given these restrictions, but within those parameters, what did you see?
Well, what I saw, I didn't see anything hit. I looked almost straight above us. There is a vapor trail coming from my right to my left, and there's a cloud of something. It looks like it might have been an explosion, a cloud, I'd say.
My apologies for that.
He's putting on a gas mask. There hasn't been any gas dropped here that we could tell.
You smell anything?
No.
Oh.
You may smell some of the fumes from a missile exhaust going off. Missiles use a rocket, a cordite, some sort of burning. And we just heard a little thump just then. But
I have to apologize for that. I caught a whiff of something and felt momentarily dizzy. You're more experienced in military affairs than I am, but it might have been a little gas from the rocket exhaust.
Well,
it wasn't anything. A lot of people have their respirators on just in case.
And again, you run to get down here. In my case, jumped out of bed hearing the air raid warning go on. You run down 3 flights of stairs to get out of here. It's probably 100 yards. You hyperventilate a little bit, and you're nervous.
One thing we have to point out, just so people won't think people are panicking, most people are in their shelters. They've taken cover in their shelters, and in the time we've been in Saudi Arabia, I've not seen any evidence of panic in the streets or people running around. People are not exactly taking this as a matter of course, but there's been no wholesale panic or anything. People are taking orderly precautions to deal with the stuff that's going on right now.
Okay, everything seems to be quiet. What I saw when I walked down, when I came running down, someone had said there is a hit upstairs over our heads, right straight up above us. And I looked up, and you could see the vapor trail, the contrail that's made by an aircraft or a rocket at high altitude. And there was a round puff of smoke that indicated something happened at that point, a lot of smoke. It could be a hit from one of the Patriots taking down a Scud missile inbound or taking down an aircraft for that matter. But right now, where we are, we have absolutely seen nothing happen. A little boom one time, a small boom, could have been the sound traveling from high on. That's not actually confirming that anything happened. We don't know that there is a hit or anything. We're just telling you what we think and what we see at this point. The air raid sirens are running. The air raid is going on. Could very well be something has happened, but we're all safe right here. The reason I'm wearing a helmet is because it's easier and safer.